everybody. This is Jimmy Rabin, the Fortify Product Manager, and I'm excited to be presenting today with Geva from Snyk. We're here today to talk about the new integration into Fortify Software Security Center from Snyk, one of the leading composition analysis tools on the market. If we look at Fortify as a whole, as most of you know, our bread and butter is both static and dynamic analysis of unknown vulnerabilities in custom code. We work really well with a tooling that deals in known vulnerabilities of open source components that are leveraged in custom built applications. So it really makes sense for us to integrate with the market leaders in the composition analysis space, so that you can co-locate those results, your Fortify results alongside your open source or known vulnerability defects in the same place. We've had a real emphasis on the Fortify ecosystem. Everything that we build from a tooling perspective has Swagger supported RESTful APIs, meaning that they are self-documenting and built into the product. We also have a GitHub page as well, github.com/Fortify, where you can see some examples of using our API. But really, the API is what drives the supportable integrations, whether we're providing many of the integrations that you see around this circle or a partner is providing it, or even a customer has developed a custom integration. It's really about integrating Fortify into the continuous integration, continuous deployment process. And we do that through the power of our APIs. Currently, Fortify Software Security Center supports importing of results from Sonatype, White Source, Black Duck, and now Snyk. So we're really happy that we're going to be able to bring Snyk vulnerabilities into Software Security Center, where they can be managed to closure, just like all of our other static or dynamically found issues. This is just a quick snapshot of what the swaggerized API reference guide looks like that's built into the product. The arrow there on the top right in Software Security Center shows you how to get to it. And as always, you can simply sniff the traffic in Software Security Center. Anything you can do in Software Security Center through the UI, you can also replicate using an available RESTful endpoint. So, without further ado, I'm going to pass it over to Geva from Snyk, and he's going to walk you through the integration into Software Security Center. Thank you very much. Geva, take it away.
Jimmy, thank you for the intro, and happy to be here talking about the integration with the Snyk and Fortify. At Snyk, we're a security startup trying to help you use open source and stay secure. And open source has been exploding and has nothing to do with the Snyk. As you can see here, the amount of downloads of NPM packages per day are already averaging hundreds of millions per day. And with this explosion in consumption of open source, there's also an explosion of vulnerabilities that come in these open source packages. And last year in 2017, we started our State of Open Source Security, which you have here a link at the bottom. And in it, we checked the top 1,000 Docker containers for vulnerabilities, and we discovered over 75% of them have known vulnerabilities in them. And so this problem is here and it's big. When you're looking at your app, this orange part can be your entire application, but only this little purple dot in the middle can be your own code. And the rest is open source components you're pulling into your application. And this might seem a negative thing, but it's actually not. It's actually a super positive thing. That means you can focus on this purple middle here, which is your core, and get the rest of the functionality from the community and not having to reinvent the wheel every time. And just to illustrate this in practice, showing here a few code samples. This is one from to fetch a file and store in S3 that we took from the Serverless Framework Example. It has only 19 lines of code and two direct dependencies here on the right. And these two direct dependencies are bringing other dependencies, so with a total of 19 dependencies, including those indirect ones. But the total amount of lines of code coming from the dependencies is 190,000. And Java isn't better than JavaScript, and so here we have a to-do application. As you can see, there's 80 lines of code on this left coming from three Java files. And overall, I'm using 7 direct dependencies here with a total of 66 dependencies if I include the indirect ones. And the amount of lines that are being introduced through these open source dependencies are over 700,000, and that's a staggering amount of lines of code coming in from open source. And of course, every line of code is an opportunity for a bug and also an opportunity for a security vulnerability. So just by the sheer amount of lines of code coming in from open source, of course, you can expect more vulnerabilities to be here. And so as you're looking at your application stack with your code relying on direct dependencies, relying on indirect dependencies, this is also your application's risk structure. In the State of Open Source Security survey that I was mentioning before, we asked the open source maintainers, how often do they audit their code? Now, 44% said they never audited their code, and 32% said they audited maybe once or twice. And so if you add those two numbers together, you get that 75% of the open source maintainers don't really audit their code for security vulnerabilities. And so if you think about it, your application's risk structure is actually more like this, where your code's relying on direct dependencies, indirect dependencies, and you also have the inherent risk from the open source maintainers themselves. But what we've seen in application security is that the investment has been disproportional, so a lot of investment in code and a little bit less investment in the open source components which are being pulled in. And so this is where Snyk comes in, tries to help you solve this problem. So how does Snyk approach this problem space? First, we focus on the developer as a key persona for our tooling. The reason for that is that developers of today are making the de facto choices on which tools get integrated into their SDLC. More than that, most organizations have 500 developers for every security person. So as long as you can get the developers to own the security for the applications they're already developing, you get so much more security power across your organization. A derivative of that is our ability to do automated remediation. Again, we focus on actionability and actually fixing the vulnerabilities, not just scanning for them. And by making this automated, we make it very easy for everybody inside the organization to fix, even developers who don't have a lot of time or developers who don't have a lot of expertise. All this is backed by our comprehensive security. We have a dedicated team of security researchers in Israel. Their whole purpose is to build the most comprehensive database of known vulnerability out there. In terms of dev-friendliness and being integrated into the modern development, we're known for integration with the source code managers, with GitHub, GitLab, Bitbucket, and the likes. We integrate with all build pipelines. We have IDE plugins. We integrate with some past and serverless frameworks. And of course, we support all the modern languages. In terms of automated remediation, Snyk will open fix pull requests and send them directly back to your repo, telling you which lines of code need to change in order to fix your vulnerabilities. And I will demo that in a few moments. In terms of comprehensive security, Snyk already powers security scanning in Google Chrome's Lighthouse, in Microsoft's Owner, in JFrog tools. Snyk was named the CVE naming authority. And even in 2018, we already opened more than 1,000 vulnerabilities. All this comes, of course, with what you need for an enterprise, comes with reporting, license compliance, single sign-on, Jira integration, the works. So what to do from here? First, I encourage you to sign up for Snyk as it is free. And there's a link below taking you to our GitHub page with the Fortify Snyk parser for you to install. So switching over to the demo, I'm here in the Snyk dashboard. Let me click on the integrations tab, which will show me all the places that Snyk knows how to connect and discover applications. I'm going to click on this add projects. I'm going to filter some because I have a lot of projects in my GitHub account. And so from my personal repo here, I'm going to import Goof and Java Goof. And I added those selected repositories. And you see they're being imported, but I've already imported them here to my dashboard. And so I have this Goof project, which is an old project, has 10 high severity vulnerabilities, 13 medium, 7 low. I have this Java Goof project that has four discovered POM files in it with 17 high, 19 medium, and 2 low. Let me click on this view report and fix. Here you can learn about which vulnerabilities you have. I have this denial of service coming in from struts to core, how it got introduced into your dependency tree, what is a recommended remediation. You can create a Jira ticket. You can ignore this vulnerability if you don't agree with it. You can take a look at this dependencies tab, which show you all the dependencies and nested dependencies that you have. And so you see here this web comment, look how many nested dependencies it's importing. And actually, we get a lot of the vulnerabilities coming in from the nested dependencies inside this application. And so in order to fix, I can click this Open a Fix Pull Request button. Snyk will ask you which one of the vulnerabilities you want to fix. I'll just select them all for the purpose of this demonstration. Click the Open Fix Pull Request button. We calculate the changes, and we will send them back to GitHub, as you will see in a second. I'm already back at github.com on this application. And so I can look at the Files Change tab, and you can see that Snyk says you need to replace a version of Spring from 3.2.6 through to 3.2.15, and instead of 2.3.20 to 2.5.12. So how do you actually get this information into Fortify? For that, you need to use the Snyk CLI. To install the Snyk CLI, you can do it as an NPM module. So NPM install minus G Snyk. Of course, I already have it installed. So after it's installed, you just change directory into a folder that has an application. So this is the same goof app that we were looking at before. And you run Snyk test. We automatically detect what type of project it is, and we scan it for you. And so here you can see all the same output that we saw in the UI. For this purpose, for the purpose of getting this data into Fortify, you need to use our dash dash JSON and save the scan results in a scan.json. So this saves it in machine readable format. And you also need to create the scan.info file to say that the engine type is Snyk, and you need to bundle them both in a scan.zip file. So switching over to Fortify, I have my applications here. Let me go into Goof. To get my Snyk info here, I click this Artifacts tab. I click the Upload Artifact button, the Add Files, select the zip file that I just created. Click here, select Snyk as the engine type, and start upload. And from here, I switch to the Audit tab. You will see all the results got imported. So first we see here Snyk Discover, there's a usage of a GPL2 license inside this application. And also you see all the other vulnerabilities, including their severity. I can look at this regular expression denial of service, got introduced to my dependency tree through STN Negotiator. It is upgradable. Snyk also knows how to patch it. You can get a little bit more information here, and you can go to the Snyk Advisory page to learn even more.